And some of you guys were asking me, hey Bryant House, why don't you reset everybody's abilities when they start coming to your fortress from the migration waves? Make sure everybody's set. Well, it's because we don't have a large enough industry right now to accommodate everybody's skills. So instead, I'll let everybody that's here just mull around, carry our stuff from point A to point B, make some friends, and then get comfortable, because they're all going to get drafted. We have a large need for dwarven warriors, so. And I think what I'll do here, well, we need water. So I'm going to be making one of these areas into a hospital. Who knows, I might just manufacture an entire hospital. That could be interesting. Yes. I'll just build it out over the water and we'll have instant wells and everything. That could be interesting. First, we'll just have to secure the area, though. So let's build some beds. Build some armor stands. Some weapon racks. Man, I want statues. I want to line and adorn our dwarven halls with statues. Okay. So, now we have a barracks for the future. No beds. But I'm gonna pause on making it a barracks for now, because we still need a unit to put in there. We have quite a bit of stuff to do, but once this is set up, we're gonna have an outpost deep down underground where the military is close, where our dwarves that go and venture and gather the resources out of this cavern are more protected. They'll never be safe, but at least they'll know that our fortress is there to protect. And I have no idea what I was going to turn this little block of space into. Maybe another entrance. I don't like to have too many entrances. You know, maybe I'll just make that the entrance, because I know it's far away from our stairs, but in this kind of situation, you want it kind of far away from your stairs. So you want several layers of traps and other things to keep the random cave creatures that are out of your sight that you didn't see coming, to capture them. So let's build traps. Speaking of, cave traps. So we'll put a group of four here. And we'll put a group of four here. And then finally we'll put another group of four here. Or two. Just to catch. Now we can put three. Just to catch anybody that got past those other ones. And that should secure the hall there. And what else do we need here? We need beds. We need to be building beds. Build us beds. Lots of them. Yes. And we'll put another furniture stockpile here. And we'll put a larger cloth stockpile right next to our clothier. And it looks like our gems are packing up. In fact, let's give them some tasks. Let's encrust our ammunition with gems. Yes, diamond tipped crossbow bolts. Shoot him, money. Shoot him. Shoot him some money. So yeah, we're gonna encrust as much furniture as we can with gems. That's how we do it. Expand our table placement here. Oh man, I'm excited because we've seen so much action so early with the kobolds attacking. It's going to be really nice later on to see the action with the goblins attacking us. Speaking of that, they will attack from the surface, and we're going to need a way to fight back. So, what I'm going to do here is begin building stairs. So our dwarves can get up onto these walls. And then they can start raining death down upon our enemies. And we also, well, we'll let them get to that. We'll let them put up those stairs. And then we'll have them start building fortifications. Okay, so I'll pause it here while I lay out the fortifications and we'll come right back. Alright, so I'm back, I'm all done. And here, I'll scroll up, I'll show you what I've been up to. Ooh, look at all that. Fortifications, extra flooring on the back side of the walls. And it looks like we also have a caravan from Dur Shabby. Sabi. Or Sabu. Sorry, that's a U. Dur Sabu. So our doors are going to be really busy building this wall here. And the fortifications. Oh yeah. Super busy building the fours. Getting everything ready. And these humans are here. Which, I like trading with humans. They're not all that bad. They usually don't have crap though. For metal type goods. Usually just bronze. So, oh yeah. Fizz widget, once you get down there, or whoever has the broker skill, we might have more than one person now. Let's see here. Oh yeah, only one broker though. Never mind. All right, so you'll happily be waiting there. Our castle's coming together. It's a little off on the right side. I know. But I might be expanding this tower. So, we'll see. Step by step. And it looks like Wolf has been slain. And another one's lying on the grass, getting shot up. Is good because they will attack dwarves, so might as well clean them up. And we'll get some trading going on while our fortress is being constructed here. and we'll go from there. So things are looking nice. Let's go ahead and trade. Oops. Trade for tea. Yeah, see, they got bronze, cinnabar, mudstone. More nice. Let's get it. No, just kidding. Want some rope? Not sure what I want to trade these guys, but let's go ahead and trade everything we got and get as much stuff as we can. Make sure that we're not trading anything like these, actually. I don't want to trade those. Do you want to trade that? Yeah, we'll trade all this. Well, if they really, really want the quivers, I'll give them to them. Because we can make them. Oh, but they have leather, don't they? Well, we'll get to that point. So we'll just go ahead and scroll down. Looks like we got horse cages. Nah, we could always use another dog. Train him up. Long land beer. Strawberry wine, prickleberry wine, prickleberry wine, white, or whale blood barrel, yeah, we'll pass on the blood, we'll use some buckets. Look at that ultra mastered pine bucket. We can use another copper pick. Iron two-handed sword? Dude, that's pimp. Yeah, sure. Somebody could use a two-handed sword, that's fine by me. Rather expensive, but hey, whatever. Really cheap copper pick. Another two-handed sword. Can't wear large, can we? I don't know if we can. Well, we'll buy it. We'll see if someone puts on a really large copper chainmail shirt. I think it's some iron, not much. But there we go, large bronze cap. Strawberry seeds, sure. And, yeah, so, here's a bin of leather. We'll get that. See, leather's pretty cheap. We'll get that one. There's another cloth one. There's another leather bin. So we're just gonna get tons and tons of leather. Because, everyone's pretty much gonna be equipped with leather. I know that there's creatures down in the deep. We'll get the cloth, I guess. That will snack right through leather, but the majority of them aren't that powerful. Especially in the top floors where we're at, so. So yeah, we got a ton of leather. I think that's all we need. So if they want to go ahead and trade with us, ooh, jellyfish, everybody loves jellyfish, right? Yeah, so we'll trade. Yep, and we give him a pretty good deal there, so should be happy. And yeah. So we have tons of leather now to go ahead and outfit all our dwarves. Just gotta turn it into armor first. And we'll get right on that right now. Oh, I just popped out a child. So apparently, I am a girl. Don't mind my manly